This 3D model, this, and this one too, are some of the most popular 3D models in the world of computer graphics. If you have ever used a 3D software before, you probably came across one of them. So in today's video, we're gonna talk about each one of them, its origin, when it was created, and for what purpose. But before we do that, I just wanna let you guys know that the Blender market is having right now its biggest sale of the year from Black Friday to Cyber Monday. So if you want to get some add-ons, materials, or 3D assets, this is your chance to do so at a 25% discount. Also, I have in the description of this video a list of the most popular and powerful Blender add-ons to help you get started and get the best deals. Number 8, the Sponza scene. Sponza is one of the most famous testing scenes in the world of computer graphics and game engines. It was initially released by Crytek all the way back in 2010. And since then, the Sponza Palace model, which is a real-world place in Croatia, has long been used to showcase graphical and lighting capabilities of game engines throughout the years. The original Sponza model was created, as far as I read online, by an artist named Marko Davrovic in early 2002. And due to its architectural structure, which is particularly complex, it has become one of the most popular 3D scenes for testing global illumination and radiosity. The 3D test scene has seen a lot of variations throughout the years, and there have been a lot of recreations for different engines with every generation of graphics. Just in April of this year, the original creator updated the scene to modern graphics, and he wrote in a blog post, "After more than a decade, the Sponza scene was overdue for an update. The new scene incorporated graphically based materials with 4K textures and high resolution geometry, which accurately matched the real Sponza RTM in Dubrovnik." Number 7, the Phlegmatic Dragon. The Phlegmatic Dragon is a test model that was released to the public by the Eurographics Conference organization back in 2007 in Prague. The model was meant to be used for research submitted for the conference, and it was used for many purposes including morphing, cutting into pieces, animations, texture mapping, color mapping, and so on. The Dragon model is comprised of 667,214 faces and is accredited by the Academy of Science of the Czech Republic, Czech Technical University in Prague. Number 6, the 3D Benchy model. Moving on, the next model is probably the most popular 3D printing model in the world. The reason behind this is that this tugboat model is designed specifically for testing the accuracy and capabilities of 3D printers. It is described by its creator, the Creative Tools member Daniel Noray, the creator behind OpenRC, Truggy, Printable Wrench, etc. It is described as the Jolly 3D printing torture test. A testing 3D model like this is needed because, using 3D printers, you might need to do things like calibration, testing, and setting up hardware before you can go ahead and print. Also, this is important to know that your 3D printer is producing models of quality and resolution comparable to other high-quality 3D printers. This deceptively cute-looking boat has been carefully designed to offer a range of challenging geometrical shapes and even colors for any 3D printer to overcome. The model is designed to print at 1:1 scale without support materials. It is often used to reveal typical issues regarding surface finish, dimensional accuracy, and wrapping or deviations. That's why it is a great tool to test and calibrate your 3D printer and adjust hardware and software settings for optimal results. This STL file is freely available under the Creative Commons license, and you can grab it from websites like Thingiverse and My Mini Factory if you want to test it yourself. Number 5, Suzanne. The famous Blender mascot Suzanne model is a chimpanzee head created by Willem Paul van Overbragen, aka Slate3, who named it Suzanne after the orangutan in the film Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back. The story behind the Suzanne model and how it came to be the mascot for Blender is linked to the final days of the original company that holds the rights to Blender, which was called Not a Number, as it was clear that the company is going down in March of 2002. The team put out one release, which was Blender 2.25, and as an Easter egg, the developers and artists at the time decided to add the Suzanne model. The Suzanne model serves the purpose of testing things such as materials, lighting, shading, and testing shadows, as it is able to cast shadows on itself, in addition to other stuff, of course. Also, it is comprised of only 500 faces, and it is often used as a quick and easy way to test materials, animations, rigs, textures, and lighting setups, and so on, as I said. Later on, Suzanne became a mascot to Blender, and even the largest Blender contest award was named the Suzanne Award. Number 4, the Stanford Dragon. The Stanford Dragon is one of those models that I'm sure you have seen a lot if you are a 3D artist, but you just can't put the name on it. Most people will be surprised to know that this is a well-known test model called the Stanford Dragon, not to be confused with the Phlegmatic Dragon. This is a computer graphics 3D test model that was created using 3D scanning back in 1996 using a Cyberware 3030 MS 3D scanner. The Dragon consists of exactly 871,414 triangles, and it was created by scanning a real Chinese dragon figurine. Similar to the previous one, the Dragon was perfect to test various graphics algorithms like polygonal simplification, compression, and surface smoothing. Number 3, the Stanford Bunny. The Stanford Bunny is one of the most commonly used test models in computer graphics. It was originally created in 1994 by Greg Turk and Mark Levoy using a technique that they developed to create polygonal models from several range of scans. The original bunny model they created consisted of exactly 69,451 triangles. The bunny went on to be a smash hit in the computer graphics world, and it was featured in many papers, and it was included in many 3D software since then. Originally, the data was used to test various graphic algorithms, including polygonal simplification, compression, and surface smoothing. Still, the model itself posed some complications when testing. For instance, the model is a manifold, which means it is connected and has holes in it. Some of this is due to the fact that it is hollow, but some is due to limitations the creators faced while scanning. But these complications provide more realistic input for any algorithm benchmark using the Stanford Bunny, though by today's standards, the model is not that great. Number 2, the Cornell Box. Now, we're gonna talk about the Cornell Box and its variations. This 3D scene was meant to be used to determine the accuracy of rendering software by comparing an actual photograph with the rendering result of the same scene. It was created by a number of students at the Cornell University Program of Computer Graphics for their paper Modeling the Interaction of Light Between Diffuse Surfaces, which was published and presented at SIGGRAPH back in 1984, which is just impressive. There were multiple variations of the Cornell Box throughout the years, but the original box consisted of one light source in the center, of a white ceiling, a green right wall, a red left wall, a white back wall, and a white floor. Objects are often placed inside the box. The first were two white boxes, but another common version was used to test photo mapping, which included instead of boxes, two spheres, one with a perfectly reflective material and the other one was made of glass. What a test scene is able to do is to showcase what we call bounce lighting, as some light should reflect off the red and green walls and bounce onto the white walls. So part of the white wall should appear slightly red or green. Computer scientists often use the scene as a test for render engines to assess their accuracy without comparing them to a real physical scene. Number 1, the Utah Teapot. Of course, the number 1 on this list is gonna be the Utah Teapot. This is arguably one of the most famous 3D objects in the world of computer graphics, which is famously known as the Utah Teapot or the Newell Teapot. This model is actually the equivalent of writing the Hello World program for programmers. It was first created by early computer graphics researcher Martin Newell back in 1975, and he was a member of the pioneering graphics program at the University of Utah. The teapot itself was the first of its kind to be modeled using Bezier curve rather than precisely measured vertices. The idea for the teapot came from his wife. As they were having some tea at home, she suggested modeling the tea set, and Newell took a pen and paper and sketched that teapot, and that was the base for the model. The original teapot is now displayed at the Computer History Museum in Mountain View, California, where it is cataloged as a teapot used for computer graphics rendering. This is the case because it was ideal for graphic experimentations, since it was round and contained a saddle point in addition to concave and convex surfaces. Also, one of the most important things about it is that it could cast light on itself, and the fact that it is immediately recognizable and could be displayed accurately without a surface texture. I hope you found this video useful and informative. If you have something to add, please leave it in the comment section below. Also, you can check some of our previous videos. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.